Free flap, Wikipedia audio. The terms free flap, free autologous tissue transfer and microvascular free tissue transfer are synonymous terms used to describe the transplantation of tissue from one site of the body to another, in order to reconstruct an existing defect. Free implies that the tissue is completely detached from its blood supply at the original location and then transferred to another location and the circulation in the tissue re-established by anastomosis of artery and vein. This is in contrast to a pedicled flap in which the tissue is left partly attached to the donor site and simply transposed to a new location, keeping the pedicle intact as a conduit to supply the tissue with blood. Various types of tissue may be transferred as a free flap, including skin and fat, muscle, nerve, bone, cartilage, lymph nodes and intestinal segments. An example of free flap could be a free toe transfer in which the great toe or the second toe is transferred to the hand to reconstruct a thumb. For all free flaps, the blood supply is reconstituted using microsurgical techniques to reconnect the artery and vein. Indications. Free autologous tissue transfer is performed by many surgical specialties. Free flaps are used to reconstruct tissue defects, particularly when postoperative radiotherapy is indicated. Vascularized free tissue is preferred over non-vascularized free tissue. Aesthetic reconstruction, most commonly creating a breast after a mastectomy. This may happen at the time of mastectomy or at a later date. Free flaps are usually only done if a tram flap is not possible. Plastic surgeons usually perform these surgeries. Patients with Bell's palsy can have their face reanimated using free-functioning muscle flaps. Breast reconstruction. Hand reconstruction. Head and neck reconstruction. When reconstructing complex head and neck defects, the reconstruction often requires bone and soft tissue from a distant donor site to be harvested. Functional reconstruction in the head and neck area often requires reconstruction of the oral cavity, the jawbone, and the dental occlusion. Type of defects include. The most common serious complication of a free flap is loss of the venous outflow. Loss of arterial supply is serious too, and both will cause necrosis of the flap. Close monitoring of the flap both by nurses and by the surgeon is mandatory following the completion of the operation. If detected early, loss of either the venous or arterial blood supply may be corrected by operative intervention. Many times an implantable Doppler probe or other devices can be installed during surgery to provide better monitoring in the post-operative period. The Doppler probe can be removed before discharge from the hospital. Reconstruction of paralyzed face or hand using functioning free muscle flaps. Usually the harvest of a free flap is performed in such a fashion to cause the least amount of disability. Despite this, some disability may occur following removal of this tissue from the donor site. Other complications/sequelae which may occur with any surgery are also possible, including infection and pain. Reconstruction of post-traumatic defects. Some areas of the body has missing tissue either from a trauma or from some existing wound. This may include areas on the leg where bone is exposed or any other area on the body that needs soft tissue coverage. Reconstruction of a defect following removal of a tumor in the mouth or elsewhere. Soft tissue resection requires soft tissue reconstruction. Composite resection requires composite reconstruction. Soft tissue flaps include the radial forearm free flap and the alt free flap amongst others. Composite free flaps include the fibular free flap, the DCIA free flap, the scapular free flap and the composite radial free flap, amongst others. When the cancer resection involves a part of the lower jaw, depending on the patient's age and the patient's comorbidities, one composite free flap will be preferred over the others for reconstruction of the defect, reconstruction of esophageal continuity using segments of intestine. Surgical steps during free autologous tissue transfer. Postoperative complications/sequelae. Bibliography.